And here are some local corporate headlines. Semirara Mining and Power declares 14.88 billion pesos in special cash dividends on top of the 14.88 billion pesos it paid out in April. This makes Semirara shareholders entitled to special cash dividends of 3 pesos and 50 centavos per share payable on November 8. Semirara shares climbed nearly 4% in Tuesday trade. Meanwhile, Alternergy's wind subsidiary in Tanay, Rizal, inks a lease with a revenue-sharing agreement with the provincial government. The company will use parcels of the local government's land to develop and implement its Tanay onshore wind project. As for Double Dragon's Hotel 101, it opened its global corporate office and sales hub in Singapore. The facility will be a hub for team members based in different countries who will lead its overseas expansion. Double Dragon's Philippine portfolio also set to fully mature and reach optimal revenue generation level by 2025. And finally, food and beverage giant RFM Corporation vows not to raise prices for its products until the year ends. Speaking to ANC, its president and CEO Joey Concepcion said, prices of raw materials for their food products have started to come down after a bad case of inflation in late 2022 and earlier this year.
With the International Monetary Fund issuing a bleak outlook on the global economy, the international body says it sees a global economy limping along as prospects for medium-term growth were mediocre. That's amid concerns over the real estate crisis in China, volatile commodity prices, and geopolitical fragmentation. It adds, while inflation continued to decline around the globe, it's not quite there yet. It urges monetary authorities not to ease interest rates too soon. The IMF in its latest World Economic Outlook left its global growth forecast unchanged, citing strength from the U.S., but it cut its projections for China and the euro area. It also slashed its outlook for the ASEAN 5, which includes the Philippines. The IMF earlier trimmed its growth forecast for the Philippines from 6.2% to 5.3%. The markets ended Tuesday trade mostly higher as the Federal Reserve's dovish tone eased rate expectations, temporarily lifting sentiment that has been dragged by the Israel conflict. Japan's Nikkei jumped nearly 2.5%, boosted by energy and distribution stocks. Australia's ASX 200 and Singapore Straits Times Index rose 1% each. Some notable stock movements in the region: Hong Kong-listed Country Garden saw its shares plunge for a second day after China's largest property developer warned it can't meet offshore debt obligations. Now, this raised worries it will join a growing list of Chinese developers that have defaulted. Meanwhile, some stocks of airline firms in the region tumbled after they were forced to cancel flights to Israel due to the conflict there. In more positive news, shares of Samsung Electronics rose on news South Korean chipmakers were given the go signal to continue shipping U.S. chip gear supplies to their China factories without additional permits. Here at home, Philippine shares gained 0.5%, with advancers outnumbering decliners.
Compared to how the markets reacted previously with the war in Ukraine. The market has been doing pretty well. It's also mainly because probably that the supply chains aren't as affected as it has been with the conflict in the Ukraine, because Israel and Palestine aren't really oil producers. Okay. It's more of Iran and Saudi Arabia, which don't really see the conflict landing on their territories. Resilience that we saw in the PSE this session could be attributed to the upcoming third quarter earnings. So investors seem to have high hopes for a favorable third quarter, which would offset the Israel-Hamas conflict worries.